This weekend, Canada will officially strike back against the president's tariffs on steel and aluminum. Midwest lawmakers worry this could be another damaging blow to American farmers. KCAU 9's Washington correspondent Jessica Smith brings us more.
We will not back down.
On Friday, Canada announced tariffs on more than $12 billion in U.S. goods. The Canadian foreign minister said after the U.S. put tariffs on steel and aluminum, they had no choice but to retaliate.
With a measured, perfectly reciprocal, dollar-for-dollar response.
Canada is targeting a variety of U.S. goods, including yogurt, coffee, toilet paper, and metals.
It's tough for our farmers right now.
Senator Joni Ernst says the president needs to fix this quickly because farmers in Iowa depend on international trade.
We're in a dangerous situation.
While Indiana Senator Joe Donnelly supports tariffs on Chinese steel, he says the administration has now gone too far.
One of the greatest things we've had in ag, in agriculture, in our markets, has been the ability to export.
Ohio Senator Sherrod Brown is one of the president's strongest supporters on tariffs, but says they need to be used correctly.
Don't play off farmers, soybean farmers, against steel workers. We can do this in a way that doesn't happen.
Brown says tariffs should not be permanent policy, but a negotiating tool to strike better trade deals, though some worry this trade tit-for-tat with Canada won't help NAFTA negotiations.
The president was fairly confident we would see NAFTA done early fall, but I'd almost say early fall is not nearly soon enough.
The Canadian tariffs go into effect on Sunday, and more Chinese tariffs will hit next week. In Washington, I'm Jessica Smith.